do each and every day. My son Wills was diagnosed with autism when he was 3 years old. Among the many false conclusions one doctor shared with us was that Wills would never read. My husband and I are both writers, and literacy has been a crucial part of shaping our lives, so we were shattered. Sure, I could always read to Wills, had been doing so since he was an infant. And he enjoyed the pictures and the sound of my voice, and he never forgot anything. In fact, Wills liked children's books, but he preferred adult ones, like Trains by Graham Outerbridge, The Cricket in Times Square, or The Schedule for the New Jersey Transit System, where his grandparents lived. Wills' board books lay in piles around the bottom of his bookshelf. He was more interested in how the golden flight was driven to the ground by Leland Stanford connecting the Central Pacific and Union Pacific Railroads on May 10, 1869 at Promontory Summit, Utah, and he could say it just like that. He used runaway bunny as a teasing device. His cardboard corner soggy and soft, so I knew. I knew what was in there, I knew it. And I knew he was brilliant, and he wanted to know things badly. And I, to teach him things, I would introduce him myself to Jane Eyre and Holden Caulfield. Still, the idea of him not reading, crushing. So my husband and I got busy. We decided that what we needed was a team, a family of sorts that could surround Wills. We got educators and therapists like you, who knew more than we did about narrating Wills' feelings for him so he wouldn't be standing alone in the world. We learned how much Wills needed repetition and structure in his life, putting up scheduling boards and giant calendars on the family room wall. If there were changes in our schedule, we would let him know as soon as possible, trying not to frighten him or surprise him. We took Wills to occupational therapy, a speech and language specialist, an educational therapist, and a social skills group. Well, our family was growing, and Wilson's improvement stunning. Well, my son is 14 years old now. He would not be reading To Kill a Mockingbird or heading to a Main Street school this fall for his freshman year if it were not for educators and people like you. That comes from a highly personal and loving place. You are the single life-changing factor in the lives of the families you work with. My husband and I loved our son, could not have loved him more. But we will be forever thankful. We will be down on our knees grateful for the therapists, teachers, and wonderful friends who gave us their time and talents, often using their vacation time, and their own money to buy supplies to help Will. As I said, when Will was diagnosed, we were told that we had bigger problems than him not being able to read, that he would also not be capable of living alone or creating lasting friendships. But luckily, we stepped back and realized he's our son. He's not a problem. There might be problems to be solved, but our children are not problems. For all the ways you've lifted and educated and just loved families like mine. As I often say about Wills' team, there are too many angels to count. And I'm here to welcome each and every one of you, angels all. NCFL whenever we can. Wills is very favorite being writing, starring in, and directing a Wonder Oppos video. Three, actually. And my favorite are all the many programs and families uniting through education and literacy down through the generations. NCFL is my family's passion, and we are lucky and we are spoiled to be a part of it. Such an innovative, caring, and smart organization.